Hold on for the loud beep.
Why is everyone making so much noise with trying to film a thing?
Hi, I'm Erika Mendez, and I play Gon.
Hi, I'm Cristina Vee, and I voice Kilua.
I'm Erika Harlacher. I play Karapika.
Hi there. My name is Matthew Mercer. I am the voice of Leorio in Hunter x Hunter. Before I started auditioning, the only thing I knew about the series was the images of Gon with the ridiculous hair. A super, super high hair. I learned about the series going into it, learned into it as we went along, and kind of, you know, fell in love with it from that point. So it was all very new to me.
When I first auditioned for Hunter x Hunter, I auditioned for Gon, Killua, and Karapika. So I remember I emailed back the studio and I was like, did you send this to me on accident? Because he's like almost an adult man. And they were like, no. Karapika's played by a woman in Japanese, and we really want him to be played by a woman in English.
It's been around for so long, and I've definitely seen the characters around before, so I knew immediately what I was going in for.
Reading for Killua, I felt him in my soul, you know? And I don't think I had many boy voices before then. That wasn't something I got to explore yet, so I was really happy when I got cast as Killua.
I love his happy disposition. Gon is just always that, and you know, he doesn't look crazy when he does it. He's just a happy person and just exudes like such bright energy. And I don't know, I guess secretly I wish I could be that type of person, but that's a lot of work, so.
Early on, I think my favorite part about Leorio was this greedy persona that he put on. You know, you think he's such a prick. You know, and he's doing this all for the wrong reasons. And there's something comical about that by, you know, juxtaposing that with everyone else who has more altruistic or, you know, reasons that are less financially and material based. But the more you get to know him, you know, that kind of falls away.
Some of my favorite moments with him are when he's like letting loose a little bit and being like one of the four friends. I love his interactions with Leorio so much. Leorio is my favorite character, besides Karapika. I feel like part of the reason Leorio is my favorite character is because of all the interactions that Karapika has with them.
For Killua, I love how many facets of his personality we get to explore. You just don't know who he is at first. He's like this cool-headed kid, but eventually you get to see that there's so much more to him. He's an assassin. But he's still so kind. And as the series progressed, we saw more and more of him. So it never stagnated. It was always, who is this guy?
I was a fan of the world building aspect of it. And just the dynamic character designs. Like every character in the series has such a different, unique visual style and color palette and power set. It reminded me of the anime that I grew up with.
One of the things that like really drew me into the show was the friendship between Karapika, Gon, Killua, and Leorio. I love them so much, and how they're all so like different and unlikely friends, but they become so close and tight, and they work so well together. Like I love the way that their missions flow when they're doing stuff together, and it's awesome.
I don't usually pay attention to too many adventure series, but this one I feel like was really nice because it definitely is a good balance of that like lighthearted comedy and then the like dark adventure story. Hunter x Hunter I think is like really well rounded, and the sort of sense that it's got like, you know, good characters, good story, it's got good music, the art's amazing. Like the monsters and like the environments look amazing, so it's just really good series all around. So it was really cool to be a part of something like that.
It's just really fun to watch so many different adventures. The whole Greed Island arc with like the card game was crazy, and you know, it makes you want to live in that world. Like people always ask, like, what world would you want to live in? And I think I would want to be a hunter because there's just so many possibilities.
I did something a little unconventional one year. I went to a convention that I wasn't invited to just so I could meet the Japanese voice of Gon. So I flew out, spent my own money just to go and meet her. And that was just an experience because, you know, you don't get that experience too often. And it was just cool to me because, like, I hear her voice so often because we do the, you know, we listen to the playback in Japanese and I, you know, do my own version of that performance. So it was just really neat getting to meet my counterpart, and because I respect her work so much. So that was really cool.
Being with Erika, who I've known for, man, if not 15 years, then maybe almost 20 years. Yeah, getting close to 20 years now. And to get to go on this journey with her, and I love doing panels and stuff together. Because our characters always end up being like, you know, like this. So it's very cool when you know the person you get to act next to. And seeing the fans' reactions to the show, people love it.
Any of Leorio's extremely loud, long tangents were so fun to perform. The more angry, more frustrated he was, the bigger his face got on screen. Those are just a blast to do as an actor.
One of my favorite things about having done this role has been at conventions and having people come up. I mean, we started recording so long ago, and Karapika, I really haven't recorded for Karapika in a while, but the show's still been going on. And if anything, I feel like there's just even more and more and more fans as time goes on, which is so awesome to see.
You know, felt proud to have been a part, proud that we got to see it off properly, and proud to be amongst such a talented cast.
There are times when I think he'd definitely like make my days brighter when I wasn't feeling so well. So it's so just thinking about that stuff and like thinking about how it was all ending was like really sad. I cried, I think, after the last, well, I cried leading up to the last session when I thought like about two or three times that I was going to have my last session. And then the final session, I did cry at the end of it when I got home. Yeah, it was definitely sad, but I'm also a big baby, so I really care about my characters, and Goen's just been so good to me, so yeah.
I got so many tweets, again, even though I haven't like been in it in a while. People were just so like, thank you, like thanking the cast and thanking everybody involved for creating something so meaningful. And it had been on TV for like between 2 and 3 years, I think.
For all of you out there who've been watching Hunter x Hunter, thank you for coming with us on this adventure and this journey. Thank you for your infinite patience for the chaos that is Leorio. And for just being so supportive and for those that had the opportunity to meet at events. It's been a pleasure, and I look forward to meeting those of you I haven't yet in the near future.
Thanks so much for keeping up. I know it's been hard. You did it. We did it. We're all stronger people for it. Thank you all for loving it the way you do.
Your passion for this show is amazing, and I am so honored that I got to be a part of it for all of you. You guys are seriously why I do this. So thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Guys, thank you so much for watching Hunter x Hunter. 10 years ago, this wouldn't have been possible. And it's so amazing that now in real time, we can share this experience together. You know, I see you guys on Twitter. I see you guys on Facebook, and we get to react and talk to each other. And I think it's a really cool and special time we're living in, and I'm glad I get to share it with you.
Thank you guys so much for supporting this fantastic series. And of course, Hunter x Hunter Set 7
is out now on Blu-ray and DVD.
So go grab it. Grab a couple. Give it to your mom, your dad, your sister, your dog, your friends.
Pretend I have chains on. Goodbye. Forever? Question mark?